Hey everyone, I'd like to introduce you to my friend Lisa Smart Anderson. She is actually taking art classes. Hey Lisa, why did you decide to take art classes? I'm not going to ask you to answer right now. You think about it and I'm going to go ahead with this, and then when you're ready, you tell me.
I'm ready.
Go ahead, let me hear it. I want to hear this.
Well, I took that one in a couple lessons with somebody and I really loved it, and I wanted to get some other techniques. And I admire you and your work, and I thought, well, what a great place to start.
This is super.
Or to continue.
Right. Yeah. And learning new things is such a great experience. It's kind of helping me cope through the COVID.
Especially now, right.
Exactly. Right. So what we've done is we've set up some plastic between us so that we can still be in the same area. And I feel comfortable.
I'm comfortable.
All right. So she's actually done a few layers on an oil painting. You have a book there. Great thing about books is a lot of them have pictures in it. And she picked out a picture just as a frame of reference. So for a face, it's good to have a frame of reference. Doesn't mean she's copying the picture. She's putting her own two cents in there. So it's not a copy at all. Today we're going to go over glazes. Now this is really neat stuff. This is called water washed walnut oil, and it's come from the Art Treehouse. The guy's great if you talk to him on the phone. What I do is I buy these little containers at Michael's. You can put beads in them, things like that, but I put oil in them, and then I don't tighten the cap up completely, because if you do that, you'll never be able to open it again. I just kind of sort of twist it a little bit. But anyway, this is the glue that you will use. So this is like water when it comes to painting with acrylics. Oil is for oil painting. So what I do is I'm giving a little demonstration, then Lisa's going to go ahead and work on her piece too. I've got two brushes here. One looks really nice and clean and one looks a little dirty. I'm going to use the dirty one. It's not really dirty. I cleaned it as well as I could. And I take a little bit of the oil and I put just a little bit of oil over top of where I'm going to put my glaze. Okay, you don't have to put the oil all over the canvas, you just put it where you want your glaze. Now in this case, we are going to go over the whole canvas, and I've got one up here. So this is just putting the oil, a nice thin coat of oil. Make sure you coat the whole thing. If you don't have it on there, what'll happen is the next layer of oil paint will just scratch right off. It'll flake off, it'll never stick. I mean, it may stick for the first 20 years, but after that, it'll start flaking off.
So can I ask you a question on that?
I'd like to hear it.
So, if you put an oil first that you're doing now,
right?
What is the glaze? I know we've talked about that. I know I've used it. The white to the oil, and then is the glaze color or is the glaze clear?
The glaze has color in it, yeah. So really, it's just oil with the color pigment inside of it, and it's real thin. So it's translucent, and you'll see. Now here's the thing, if you put too much oil on, number one, it'll take forever to dry. And number two, it'll take forever to dry. So really, don't put a lot of oil on. So then what I do is I take a rag and I wipe it all off. And believe you me, even if I do wipe it off as best as I can, you know how hard it is to get oil off your fingers? Like when you finally get it off, it's hard. So there will be a very thin layer of oil. And that's how I begin. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give Lisa...
Can I take this out of the plastic?
Yeah, you can take it out of the plastic. I'm going to give Lisa the same brush. There we go. Put these over here. This is totally off the cuff. I did not plan any of it. I know, isn't it awesome?
I tried to do the backward mirror thing.
That's
right?
Layer number three. We're doing five layers total. So I'm going to pass this over to her, and she's going to do the same thing that I just did while I go ahead and demonstrate the next section. You can use this if you want to wipe it off with.
Okay. Is that the same thing like when you use the rag?
Yeah. Okay. And actually, you could use this rag. I don't know where I put my other rag. No, I'll keep that one. All right. So right here, I have four colors for my glaze. I have black, I have burnt umber, which is a brown, I have a burnt sienna, which is kind of a reddish, and I have a really dark blue, super dark blue. Now, the thing about it is you can use black paint. You really can. You don't ever have to use another color. Or you can mix black paint by taking some burnt sienna, which is like an orangey. See that there? And then you take just a little bit of the blue. See that there? And then you mix the two of them together, and you get a nice, deep, dark black, okay? You'll have to find the amount, a little bit of that, and find the amount there. Okay, so that's going to give me, I shouldn't have that there. That's going to give me a nice, dark black. Lisa, what was that question you asked me earlier about black paint?
Oh, I asked you, why do you mix like a blue and a sienna with black to make black when you've already got black?
I know, like
that's a reasonable question.
It is. It is. It's sort of like if you can go to the store and buy boxes of pasta, why do people make pasta then? Why do they?
Yeah, but they're not mixing different pastas together to make a pasta.
But you know when you make homemade pasta, you can tell the difference.
Yes, definitely.
Okay, the same thing. You can tell the difference. Instead of just using black straight out of the tube, mix your own black up. What happens is when you thin that black out, it's so neat. It comes with different hues. Sometimes it's orangey, sometimes it's bluey. It comes alive. That's the difference there. So that's why I do it. You don't need a whole lot of pigment for this glaze. And then I need some oil.
Do you have an extra?
Yeah, I'll have one of those little back. This little tube here. I have one. You can take that back now.
Should I cap it?
Or you don't have to. We're going to be using it a little bit more. All right, there's only a tiny bit of oil in here. Hardly any. You don't really need any. Like I said, if you use too much, it'll never dry.
I've got a lot.
There's so many brushes out there. Look at this. This is a round brush. This one's got an angle to it. That one's flat. It really doesn't matter which brush you use, but if you find a brush that you enjoy, use that one. That's how I do it.
That's a good philosophy.
I mean, here's the thing is you can go in the store and there's 1,000 different kinds of cheese to buy.
Right.
So which cheese do you get?
The one you like.
The one you like. Right. So I personally like this angled brush. I think that is just fantastic. Okay, so what I'm doing is I take just a little drop of the oil and you can see how it thins out. Okay. Thins it out. And then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to find some of these dark areas in here. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to give a dark area there, and a dark area there, and a dark area over here. So I'm just finding some contrast. Okay, just a little bit of contrast. Now, here's the thing. I say, oh my gosh, I don't like it. So watch this. Look at that, it just disappeared completely. It's gone. Ha ha, I get to start from scratch. You can't do that with acrylic. You have to paint over.
And doesn't the oil make that easier that you put underneath?
Yes, it does. Thank you for adding.
Makes sense.
Okay, so that's a quick glaze on that one. Up here, I'm going to add a quick glaze on that. So I'm really just kind of finding the lines that I am appreciating. And I want to define those lines a little bit more. Doesn't mean you have to do every single one. And the lines don't have to be perfect, because if they were perfect, you could go ahead and print a photograph. You wouldn't even need to paint it, right? So it's kind of nice to see imperfections. I mean, a real person made it. Okay, so anyway, I've got an idea of, boy, I put some heavy duty eyebrows. So then what you can do is take a dry brush and you can lift some of that off or blend it even better. Blend. There we go. Imagine doing this 13 hours a day. Some days I just love doing this. All right, so right now I want to take a look at Lisa's. Lisa and Nicole. I need that piece of acetate. Was that around there somewhere?
Oh, yeah.
Now, I know some art teachers that I've had, I'm just sharing their stories. I don't really know any of this information. I'm sharing what they told me. So all these know-it-alls told me, and so now I'm sharing it with Lisa. What we have here is a piece of acetate. And so as an art teacher, you can go ahead and paint right on the student's work. You are allowed to do that. You are the art teacher. But in this case, what I'm going to do, and you can't really see that because the acetate, I wonder if I come down here a bit.
Sort of. Wow. It makes it look kind of psychedelic.
It does, really. What the heck? You know what? I have another sheet of plastic. Maybe I'll go get that because this is... I'll be right back.
Some wax.
Lisa, talk amongst yourselves.
Remember that waxy kind of stuff we used to use that had a little sheen in like, I don't know, art class in high school? It had like a sheen on one side. Vanilla paper, maybe? I bet you could use that too.
It was in high school?
Yeah, I'm thinking that would be sort of the same purpose. Because you're actually going to paint on that to demonstrate for me what I might do, right?
You can hire them. Well, shoot, this works in person. you can kind of, let me see how that. Ooh, look at that. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to turn this down a bit so y'all can see it better.
There you go.
Yeah, there Perfect. We go. See, lesson learned.
It's not as fun, but it's more realistic.
There we are. Okay, now I'm looking at her photograph. Not her photograph, but her drawing that she's using for inspiration.
The dead girl.
she's saying, let's see.
Here you go. You want to see it?
Yeah. So this is, she calls her the dead girl because, of course, this girl is...
She's passed away like 200 years ago, at least. That's an original sketching.
Yeah.
But she lives on through you.
She does, and lives on now through you. How's that? Yeah, that's nice. All right. I really like to use big brushes. It really helps when I'm trying to get a project done. If I use a tiny little brush, it takes a lot longer.
You got a tiny one right there.
Yeah.
Like one little horsehair.
Yeah, if you spent the whole day painting with that brush, you would never...
You wouldn't paint again.
You could never paint the whole canvas. It would take you hours. So do a big brush to begin with. So I'm going to go ahead and say, Lisa, let's work on the perimeter, the outside. Let's not work on her face for a second. Let's just work on the outside. So you're going to want to cover up all the outside, the whole thing. You just cover that up.
Am I doing that with the black that we're mixing?
Yeah. I've also got some burnt umber, which is the, like, brownish color, and that's always old. It makes it look old. And these paintings, or these drawings, these are French Impressionism, so over 100 years old. Mm-hmm. And you know, if it's old, it usually gets brown and dingy. So it adds to the ambiance of the painting. So look, we're going to pull that darkness all the way around. The other thing is, if I look, one side of her face has a lot of light, the other side of the face doesn't. So we're going to take some of either the dark burnt umber or black, and we are going to darken up that one side of the face, okay? So here, we're going to fill that in, okay? And we're going to fill in her eye, and then we're going to fill in the side of the nose, and we're going to fill in over here. So basically, whole side of the face is dark. We're going to fill all those in. Same thing with the hair. We're going to fill in a lot of the hair. The hair really isn't the focal point, so we're going to go ahead and fill that in. What you want the focal point to be is this cute little spot right here. You see it?
Is that on the nose, you mean?
This is a cute little spot of the chubby little cheek.
Oh, where it's lit up?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
And then that cute little button nose. And I see a little bit of happiness. So we're going to go ahead and define some of these areas. Okay, so we're going to fill in all that area on the side so we can get our darks. And then the neat thing about it is we can always lift some of these off and then blend. So just keep blending, pushing. All right, are you ready to go for this?
I'm going to give it a try. Now, you know, I darkened her once. But I'm going to come back and do a more blended shadow look, right?
Yeah. So We'll go ahead and we're going to take a break, let Lisa work on her painting, and maybe we'll come back live.
And we'll see it.
And we'll see it. It's still got one more layer after today, and that layer is actually the finishing touches, and that's what like really pulls it together. So I'm going to go ahead and hand this back over.
Okay.
All right. Anyway, it's good to see you guys. I hope I'm bringing joy to your life here by putting these little things on. I know being stuck in the house is just really difficult. But
you could be stuck here behind a plastic sheet. That would be a lot more fun.
Handy dandy plastic sheet. Oh, by the way, it's Art Walk on Friday. I'm going to have this plastic up, so if you come in here, just do it one at a time or two at a time. Don't crowd me. But I'm going to have the plastic up, and that way we're kind of safe. All right, well, we'll see you later.